Okay, now with any STEDI kit wiring harness, you're gonna get supplied the full kit that comes with your relays, switches and all. But one of the things that comes with a factory harness is this switch here. Now, it's just a generic switch which will go into any hole that you can cut that size and plug into your dash canopy, wherever you wanna put it. But what we also offer are some vehicle specific switches. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to wire up this vehicle specific switch to the STEDI factory harness. You're gonna need a few tools, some basic tools, just some wire cutters slash strippers. I've got a soldering iron here, you can either use electric or I've got a gas one here. Some solder, of course, and some heat shrink. What's provided is this little instruction manual. Now you need to follow that to wire this up. The first thing you notice on this little manual that there's no colors actually shown in there, and that's for a good reason. Now to avoid any issues with the manufacturing process, we actually want to look at the position of the wire rather than the color of the wire itself. So firstly, once you've got your plug and harness that's supplied for the factory fit, you want to find the connection on the generic harness. So this is the plug that goes into the generic STEDI harness for your lights. Now that has a black, blue and white wire, so I found that plug on the main harness and just cut off the end there because we're not going to need that anymore. So once you've got your three wires off the STEDI harness, then you now need to identify what they are on this factory harness. So you just want to face the plug the same way that it shows in the image there. And then you want to start with the first wire number one. So that here in this case is the black wire, and that's the earth and ground, which is also the black on the STEDI harness. So what you're going to do to connect them, you first just want to take off about 10 mil of the sheath on both parts of the harnesses. And then you just want to use a little bit of heat shrink and make sure you put that on there before you connect the wires. Then you simply just twist the two wires together. So number two you want to look at on here is the blue wire. Now that one's not going to be connected into this harness because what that is for your light dash signal. So what you want to look for is maybe like a cigarette lighter signal or something on your dash that triggers your dash lights. And what that'll do is actually turn this switch on and give it that little blue LED there. So you can see where the switch is when it's in the dark and your lights are on. So the next one after that, wire number three in this case, is the green wire. Now that connects to your relay or your accessory. So what that is the blue wire on the STEDI harness. So same deal, you take off about 10 mil and then the blue one on the STEDI harness. Now I'm doing the soldering technique here. Now that is to give it more sort of durability and longevity in this connection, but you can use butt connectors if you just want to go for that crimp style as well. And then the final wire, number four here, is the red wire. Now that is connection, basically the source wire that gives it the power. Strip that off, and that is the white one on the STEDI harness. Always remembering to put a little bit of that heat shrink before you twist the wires together. So now what it should look like, you should have the blue one there ready for your dash lights, the black connected to the black one, green to the blue, red to the white, and that is going off this wiring diagram here. So you want to make sure that the order of the wires match those colors, and then you're ready to solder. So you just want to get your solder heated up. You can either use an electric one, but I've got a little gas one here, that's what I prefer. Once it's warmed up, you just want to tin the end of that and put a little bit of solder between each of the connections. You don't want to go overkill on this, you want just enough so it connects the two wires together but doesn't cause a massive blob on the end. Once that's done, you just want to join these wires down, lay them down a bit so you can pull the heat shrink over the end of it. You can either use heat shrink or electrical tape, but a fine heat shrink has a bit more seal when it comes to water and stuff like that. And then if you're like me, you want to finish off with a nice clean installation, I like to get a little bit of electrical tape around the whole bunch of three wires and just run it around all three to keep them together. And that is how you connect a factory style plug to a generic harness.